Welcome back into the Bob Carpenter Center for today's Delaware men's basketball contest against the UNCW Seahawks. The Hens 8-8 on the season, UNCW 4-11. Both teams 1-2 in conference play. I'm Scott Klatsch alongside Bill Harmon on your home for Blue Hen Sports, 94.7 WDSD FM. And for the second time in 9 days, Delaware takes on the Seahawks, coming off of a win the first time around on the road.
Well, coming off of Friday night, it's important we have a short-term memory that way, but a long-term memory regarding UNCW. We played great defense down there. We did a terrific job on Devontae Kaycock, and we want to replicate that, get to the foul line a little bit more, make sure we do a great job on our defensive glass. This is a very fine offensive rebounding team. Get back in transition and get ourselves going through Eric Carter early on in possessions.
Let's get to the starting lineups presented by your local Chevy dealer. Visit ChevyDealer.com for UNCW. First, a visiting team, 0-5 on the road away from Trask Coliseum this year for C.B. McGrath's squad. Jalen Forns, Jordan Talley, and Ty Taylor, your guards. Jordan Talley became a 1,000-point career scorer the other night against Towson. The forwards, Marcus Bryant and Devontae Kaycock. Kaycock, an all-CAA first-team preseason selection for the Seahawks. He stands 6'7", the junior from Alpharetta High School in Georgia. For Delaware, nothing changing. Ryan Daly, Ryan Alley, Ryan Allen, Champ Mosley are your guards. The small forward is Kyrie Walker, and the man in the middle is Eric Carter. Carter and Mosley, your captains for this 2017-18 Delaware team. Delaware coming out in their home white uniforms, blue Delaware across the chest, blue numbers, yellow trim on the Delaware and blue trim on the pants. UNCW comes out with several colors going on their Adidas uniforms, with a navy jerseys, a teal UNCW across the chest, yellow and white trim on the jerseys. Delaware playing their road blue jerseys the other night at home. Now they're back to the whites. The officials tonight, Justin Porterfield, Alfred Smith, and Clarence Armstrong. Armstrong, a Delaware native. The coaching matchup, Martin Inglesby in his second season with Delaware from Notre Dame. C.B. McGrath in his second season with UNCW, coming off a national championship win as an assistant to Roy Williams last year with UNCW. Ball is in the air. Double tap goes to UNCW. They'll get the basketball first, going right to left as we see it seated across from the Delaware home bench. Taylor with the basketball to begin. And he gets it to Talley, of course. He'll get a touch inside quickly to Devontae Kaycock on the right block, to the right hand, fading and missing. A hook shot short of the rim, an air ball into the hands of Kyrie Walker. Now Mosley wants to push. Ryan Allen will send it back to Champ, and he'll run the offense.
Good job by Ryan Daly digging in there. We're playing a little 1-2-2 zone to open up. We usually start man, but a little zone tonight seemed to bother Kaycock a little bit on that. He took a bad angle jump hook.
Daly, a catch on the wing, a ball fake. Mosley with the basketball, 10 to shoot for Delaware, and a long jump shot, a rarity for Anthony Mosley, but he knocks it through from about 17 feet on the wing. A difficulty today for both teams with the shot clock, as we mentioned during the pregame show, some malfunction with the technology of the rim on one side leads to both teams having to find the shot clock on the floor in the corner in today's game. So nothing above the rim for either team. Talley's shot on the baseline misses, and 0-2 start for UNCW as the ball is knocked out of bounds by the Seahawks. It'll go back to the Hens. But how does that make it more difficult for these players operating when they're used to looking above the rim and it's not there?
Well, one thing Delaware wants to do this afternoon, Scott, is try to make UNCW defend for longer periods of time. So finding the shot clock, the point guard, whoever ends up with the balls, got to be able to take a look because it's so low. You're usually looking up the basket. Now you're looking into one of the corners.
It's in that right corner on the floor as Mosley gets to the free throw line, nearly travels, keeps his footing. 10 to shoot as they go back to Daly. Hens up 2-0, second possession. He'll bring to the left side, a pass to Walker, open for a three, squares, good form, around, spins twice, misses, into the hands of Eric Carter, who puts it up and in.
Early on, great physicality by Eric Carter, a little ward off there of Kaycock, who fell to the floor, and then Carter was able to put it in unobstructed, but nice job positioning by Eric Carter and being physical, finishing up.
That second spin around the rim allowed Carter to get position. Taylor with a three in the corner to make it 4-3, hands on top.
The scouting report on Taylor is make him play off the dribble. He cannot be afforded standstill shots. He's got a very good left-handed high arcing shot.
Taylor, the sophomore from Wichita State. Daly missing on a three quickly as Delaware gets into their offense, and a rebound by Ty Taylor, a guy that can bound the basketball well. He's got two double-doubles on the season in his first year with UNCW. Forns in the corner in front of the Delaware bench. Bounce pass to Bryan. Another bounce pass. Corner Jalen Forns. The three is up and in. Same spot as the last possession. Taylor got one through.
Well, that's Eric Carter's side, so he's got to push out a little bit more in the bottom part of the 1-2-2. What we can also do is choke off the middle a little bit more by compressing our zone initially and then expanding out as the shooters start to square up.
Inside to Carter, a little high, a little quickly, and goes out of bounds. Carter communicating with his freshman. That should be a chest pass, not over my head.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Not only a chest pass or a bounce pass, the greatest way to attack man-to-man or zone when you spot up in the high post to mid post, just throw a bounce pass, fake one way, and then drop it in the other. That time, just no chance for Eric Carter to react to that over-the-head pass.
First turnover for Delaware. 6-4 is the Seahawks' lead as they've got back-to-back three-pointers. To get an early lead, almost 3 minutes into this contest at the Bob Carpenter Center. Jordan Talley with the basketball deep right side. Delaware in the zone defense. Screen comes from Kaycock high. Bounce pass to Forns. Forns on the wing. Back to Talley. Talley will fire away for another three, missing that time. And out of bounds it goes towards the Delaware bench. Forns couldn't track it down.
An excellent job up top by Anthony Mosley contesting the shot by Talley, who has a tendency to jump forward on his jump shot. He went straight up, so there's no problem there with fouling. You've got to be careful about these jump shooters that lean in so they don't get one of those cheap fouls on you.
Ball went out of bounds towards where Kevin Anderson is sitting, the freshman out for the season with the knee injury, but good to see him back with the team after surgery. He was on crutches today, and we wish him all the best as Carter gets the basketball. Stripped from behind by Jordan Talley in a frustration foul by Eric Carter trying to reach to get it back.
Talley came from underneath. Eric Carter did a nice job with a shot fake there to elevate Kaycock, and he was attacking along the left baseline. Talley comes from the opposite side to dig in. They may be doing a little bit of that to make sure Kaycock does not get into foul trouble.
First foul on Carter, first on Delaware, and with 16:30 left in the first half, the Seahawks another chance to extend their lead. UNCW is 2 of 5 from the field, but 6 points on 2 threes as Taylor attacks, kicks out Forns. Forns has 1 3, another on the way, and 2 down for Jalen Forns. It's 9-4 Seahawks.
When UNCW attacks along the baseline, the top part of the zone will compress to start to get their rotations, and that time that left Forns wide open at the left part of the arc.
Walker one dribble and pass to Daly. Daly 0 of 1 to begin this game in 4 minutes of action. He drives on Forn to the cup, stops off the window and in. That's a heck of a move by Ryan Daly.
I love it when Ryan Daly attacks and then uses his physicality to pull up.
Taylor quickly on the other end, bangs into a Delaware defender. Second foul called on the Hens. That'll send us to a timeout. Ty Taylor will shoot a couple when we return. Early in this game, Seahawks up 9-6, 15-51, first half.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Back into the Bob Carpenter Center early in this one. Delaware trails 9-6. All three made baskets by UNCW on three-point shots. 2 from Jalen Forns and a triple from Ty Taylor, who's at the free throw line.
This is a team that likes to shoot the three, especially in transition. But what has happened here with our zone, we get compressed at times and can't locate the shooters and run them off the three, which is going to be really important. Let's look to see if Delaware doesn't switch out of the media timeout to go back to some man-to-man, or at least have it where you play zone on a make and man-to-man on a miss. A lot of teams like to do that just to throw off the rhythm of the offensive team.
I called him Tyrod Taylor. I got NFL football on my mind. The Bills, Jaguars,
yes,
tied
you do.
At no points, almost through two quarters in that one. Benny Pinnell will have scores at the half for you as well, but he does make 2 free throws. That's Ty Taylor, and now an 11-6 lead for the Seahawks. Delaware with the basketball. Allen, who shot Barry won the second half against the Seahawks a couple games back. Misses on the three from the wing, right side. And back to UNCW it goes. Allen slumping a bit from three over the last two games since making four down in Wilmington, North Carolina. 11-6 the count. Kaycock back to Talley. They work it up top to Taylor. Taylor driving, stops at the foul line, and that shot's good. Taylor off to a hot start. He's got seven, which eclipses his six-point total last time these two teams face one another.
Walker made him go to his right. He's a lefty, and we know the scouting report is when he goes right, he's going to pull up and shoot the jumper. Walker's got to be a little bit more connected to him in that.
13-6 the Seahawks lead. Their largest early stages, just under 15 minutes left in the first half as Daly gets it straight away to Allen on the wing. He'll drive, spin in the foul line, loses grip, but a foul is going to be called against Ty Taylor. That'll be the first against the Seahawks.
I like it when Ryan Allen puts the ball on the floor. He's known as that spot-up shooter, so he's getting closer attention. He'll be crowded to chase him off the three. Now he shot fakes and gets into places where he can score and then set up his teammates. Delaware also switched defenses out of the media, playing man-to-man that last possession.
He gave the foul to Jordan Talley, so his first, not Ty Taylor. UNCW on a 13-2 run. They were down 4-0 to start and now have a 13-6 lead over Delaware. Sky Johnson in the game. He sets the screen for Mosley, who sends the basketball to the corner. Ryan Allen. It's deflected and out of bounds. It'll stay with Delaware. 7 seconds to shoot off the inbound. 14-33 first half.
Last year, UNCW got their hands on the basketball so many more times. This year, they're playing a little bit more passive under McGrath, just trying to stay in front and then contest shots from there.
Allen will be the inbounder, sideline right to Mosley. 6 seconds for Daly. Daly in NBA range, three is in. He's got five, and Delaware up to nine. They trail 13-9. It's Taylor trying to get a three right back, cannot. Quick end of the shot clock, and it falls right into the hands of Anthony Mosley. To Daly on the wing, guarded by Forns, right side. He'll take him to the rim. Attacking is Daly, tough angle. Mosley tries to tip it, but he crashes into Ryan Daly, who is following his shot, and back to UNCW it goes. Here's Taylor, bounce back behind Kaycock, but he was able to reach for it, grab it, and in one smooth motion, get it to the rim and in.
Sky Johnson got caught underneath in the offensive rebounding position, could not sprint back. Delaware's got to defend the lane first with the additional players and then push out to the three.
Mosley, a foul line jumper off the rim. He fouled his shot but can't grab it. Two players down for Delaware underneath the Seahawks rim, and UNCW has some numbers if they act quickly. Taylor, a jab step on the wing. His team up 15-9 to Kaycock, fading away, missing from the left mid-block, and he's fouled by Sky Johnson. Two free throws coming up for Devontae Kaycock, who's in the rare club of players that shoot a higher percentage from the floor than they do from the free throw line. 64% for Devontae Kaycock from the field, just 62% from the free throw line.
When you shoot from 3 or 4 feet and get dunks and run the court in transition, you probably are going to shoot a higher percentage. I mean, he's very good around the basket, but that's one where Sky Johnson's got to know, Scott. I can't foul him there. Kaycock not known for that mid-range shot. Make him score over top of you from that area and do not put him at the foul line, even though, as you've already noted, not a great free throw shooter.
Does make the first, 16-9. Now the score for the Seahawks. We see Jay Estime in for the first time, the freshman, 5 points per game. And Kaycock ups his average a bit, making two free throws on that trip. 17-9, Seahawks lead it by eight. It's their largest lead as we approach 13:30, first half of basketball. Allen over to Darian Bryant, Champ Mosley as they swing and have a catch beyond the arc. Bounce pass inside to Johnson. Johnson's wraparound layup attempt is too strong. Now Talley looking to push. He'll stop, pop just inside the top of the key, three-point arc, and a rebound by Ryan Daly after the miss. He'll go across half court where he's picked up by Jalen Forns. Couple inside-out dribbles. Mosley back to Daly. Daly will drive inside the paint. He cuffs it to the cutter. Mosley, contact at the rim. Shot does not fall, but slow to get over was Jordan Talley, and he'll pick up his second. He's frustrated by it, but he might have to take his seat with 13:02 and his second foul call.
Talley was rotating. I think he caught his heels without the monitor. I can't be 100% sure on the arc in front. So that's why Mosley out of control almost did have the offensive foul called on it, but a nice attack. And I like it when Ryan Daly, Scott, brings the ball up for us. It plays as our point guard. That relieves Ryan Allen of any stress where he's better off using the screens. And that also allows Mosley to get into the flow of the offense from another position.
Yeah, Daly not on paper the point guard of this team, but leads the team with 42 assists on the season. Mosley shot 0-5 in that game against UNCW. He's done a nice job of bouncing back from that performance at the free throw line over the past couple of games and makes two there. It's 17-11, a six-point lead for the Seahawks as Forns brings it up. We'll see a foul underneath as Kaycock was working hard for position against Sky Johnson. He's whistled for the foul, his first.
Well, he cleared him out with the left elbow. Sky Johnson's physicality is a factor in there. He's a big man to move, not necessarily height-wise, but girth, and he does a good job of holding his ground. And that time, Kaycock working for that additional 2 feet of position gets the Wardall foul.
Third foul on UNCW. Daly posting up Forms. Inside, close, up and under, move, draws contact. That's the fourth foul now on the Seahawks, and Daly will shoot two.
Good versatility in Ryan Daly's game. We've already seen him play in the mid-range, driving the ball and pulling up. We've seen him hit the three. He shared the ball with some good passes. Now he has Forns underneath him. He backs him down and gets great post-up position to almost get a three-point play inside. But I just love the fact that Ryan has so many different ways to score for Delaware.
One of those ways at the free throw line makes the first, second no good. A rebound, Sky Johnson. That looked like the end of the game at Trask Coliseum with Daly missing a free throw, but the Hens getting an offensive rebound. They had two of those in the closing minute of that game to secure the 58-56 victory. So Hens down 17-12 as Daly has it again on the wing. Picks up his dribble looking for help. He'll bounce it to Sky Johnson, right block. 11 to shoot for Delaware. Taking it to Kaycock, too strong to left-handed push shot, middle of the painted area. And a rebound by UNCW off the miss. It's Gary playing point guard for Talley, who's on the bench with two fouls. Estime, as they weave beyond the arc, gets it to Gary, the freshman. Back to Estime. Talley, the leading scorer with 7 points, goes to Forns. Forns looking to get it to Kaycock. Good defense preventing that by Sky Johnson. 10 to shoot as Taylor taps his head deep left side. Screen comes, staying up to the right side. He'll pull up from about 17, missing strong. Forns an offensive rebound, power dribble, trying to go back up over Daly. And Daly without fouling, not much you could do against Jalen Forns, who had good position on the offensive glass.
Forns and Taylor for guards are excellent offensive rebounders, much like Anthony Mosley. Just got good position there, but it wasn't that Daly had done a bad job. The rebound came out so far it fell into Forns' outstretched arms.
Allen finding a way in amongst the trees, dribbling left to right. The lefty on the right side got it to go. Delaware's down by 5. Forns trying to extend it, but a miss quickly into the shot clock, into the hands of Mosley. Outlet pass down the floor to Bryan. He'll slow things up back to Allen. Hands down 19-14 as Allen gets the corner to Daly. Ball fake, driving to the rim, stripped from behind, but the second foul on Jalen Forns will send us to a break. 11:09 remaining in the first half, and Delaware trails it 19-14. Back in a moment. Here with Bill Harmon, Benny Pinella producing back in the studio, and Ryan Daly got fouled as we went to break by Jalen Forns, his second, 5 on the Seahawks, but Daly finding ways to get to the rim, and he's at his best, and we've said this for 2 seasons now, when he's attacking the rim.
You're absolutely right. What I like about Ryan is he's gotten a better feel for some of the angles. He attacks along the baseline, but when he attacks from that mid lane area, he gets himself right at the edge of the basket, which gives him the best chance to get fouled. And we were talking about that in the pregame and how he's really looking to do that more.
Ryan Allen with a jump shot. And Delaware back to a one possession lead for UNCW. They led by as many as eight, now a 19-16 advantage for the Seahawks. Taylor trying to get into Kaycock. Guarded closely by Carter, just checked back in. Kaycock spinning, baseline, hooking, and a nice touch on that right-handed baseline shot by Kaycock. It goes through.
Very difficult angle there for Kaycock. He's got to go to his right shoulder, though. He's very good to his left and forces himself there. We need to overplay him.
Bounce pass into Carter. Carter will go up against Kaycock to his right hand. Draws the foul on Kaycock, his second. Delaware has three starters of UNCW now, all with two fouls in Forns, Kaycock, and Jordan Talley.
And that's a huge factor. We talked in the pregame show about Kaycock fouling out and only getting about 30 minutes in game one down at Trask. Here, low position by Eric Carter, using his inside hip and shoulder to force his way in. Sky Johnson also had great position earlier and just happened to miss that little left-hand jump hook.
Carter, a 63% free throw shooter, will make the first. And we see Trey Kalina come in, a seven-footer, transfer from Chattanooga, also played at Coffeyville Community College. That's a pretty good football school, as I know, Coffeyville, as Carter makes the second, but Kaycock gonna head to the bench for those two fouls.
Kalina not nearly as physical inside as Kaycock or as mobile, so Delaware needs to be able to take advantage of this with Eric Carter.
21-17. Kalina with the basketball, left block. It's Carter in the air. Shot blocked by Eric Carter. What a swat by the big man, his 11th of the season.
Well, Kalina got Eric Carter up in the air, but he couldn't take advantage of that with his quickness or lack thereof, and then stepped under, and Eric Carter perfectly positioned to time that block.
They go to Taylor. Taylor dribbling left to right. Estime will pull up and try the three, rattles in and out. Good box out by Carter, and he draws a foul on Trey Kalina. I've never seen this before, worth noting to those not here and listening on the radio. Trey Kalina has his entire name on his jersey. I've never seen a first and last name on a jersey before. It seems odd to me. I saw the T on his back and I looked down and I'm like, calling this guy by the wrong name. His entire name is on the jersey.
Well, Kalina certainly there did not have the position that Kaycock normally gets and just succumbs to the temptation of coming over the back instead of working for a good position or recognizing that the opponent is in better position. Now you just sprint back on defense.
Nice shot by Carter making the first of the 1-1 as that was the seventh foul on the Seahawks, and he makes them both. It's a two-point game. 21-19, UNCW's lead, 9:54, first half of basketball, and UNCW playing without Talley, without Forns, without Kaycock, so it's Taylor trying to make something happen, and he draws the foul against Ryan Allen. Allen's first, just the fourth on Delaware, but Taylor will go back to the free throw line where he's 2 of 2.
Taylor loves to score at the rim when he goes to his left, but that time he was actually going away from the basket, and Ryan Allen's got to understand there, just contest the shot, but do not foul that driver. His chance there making that shot was very slim.
Taylor at the free throw line, 72% on the season. Did not play very well against Delaware a couple of days ago. 6 points versus the Hens, a season low in scoring. But he's over that mark already. Is 9 points after making two. Gets the lead back up to 4 points for the Seahawks. Ryan Allen on top. Gets it to Daly. Daly, leading scorer for Delaware with six. He drives, draws contact from Brian. No whistle as the ball goes over the rim. Out of bounds, it'll stay with Delaware. Daly kind of looking back at the official saying, where was the no call?
Daly has great composure for a tough competitor who gets knocked to the ground a lot. I thought he definitely drew that foul because he was attacking the rim. The defender was coming into him.
Mosey will throw it up. Daly saves it from going back court as he touched it in the front court. You can go back court as long as you don't touch it in the front court. And Daly had to save it to Ryan Allen, who now penetrates, fakes the pass, and then wraps it around the seven-footer to go in his fourth point.
Well, that's a really acrobatic and creative finish there by Allen as he attacked the big man and got him up in the air, which is exactly what you want to do to a shot blocker. Attack his midsection or get him up early.
Brian drives, kick out Gary, the freshman, long range three off the mark. Brian looked like he pushed off, but got the offensive rebound, a miss by Brian into the hands of Darian Bryant for Delaware up the court with a chance to tie or take their first lead since it was 4-0. Anthony Mosley at the free throw line brings it back out. Carter wants it against Kalina. Back to Daly. Repositioning as Carter. He gets it back. Left block. Double team comes. Bounce pass inside Mosley. He gets his man in the air. Draws contact. And the foul.
So the game plan against Carter is to bring a weak side defender underneath. So when he drop steps on the left side, there'll be a stealer there. And that time Eric did a great job of recognizing that. Two things he can do. One, he can be told from the backside that the trap is coming. And two, he can face up and then attack, and he can locate that help defender as he comes. That was really good offense by Delaware and Eric Carter, who's utilizing his low post position to his advantage.
Anthony Mosley makes the first free throw. He leads the team in free throw attempts per game on the season. He shoots 71%, third highest percentage on the team. Second highest now that Kevin Anderson's stats are kind of canceled out for the rest of the way. Mosley makes them both. He'll get a breather. Kyrie Walker will check in. It's Walker, Allen, Carter, Daly, and Darian Bryant on the floor for Delaware as we are tied at 23-all.
Delaware's gotten back in this game via their defense, and the shift from zone, which we opened into man-to-man, has been the big difference.
UNCW's missed their last four from the field. Kalina bangs into Carter, reach-in foul on Ryan Allen, who tried to come in and take the basketball away from the seven-footer.
Well, Eric Carter got himself positioned on Kalina's left shoulder and really took a big hit as he spun back in. The help was coming on the dig, and that's what how the foul was created there by Ryan Allen.
Just a fifth on Delaware. No free throws. Inbound on the right side. They'll go to the seven-footer, Kalina, transferred from Chattanooga. He'll pass it back out to the freshman, Gary. Taylor's had the hot hand. He goes to Estime. Back to Taylor. Taylor on top. They work it around the perimeter. Now with nine to shoot. Back out goes Taylor. He taps his head. Screen comes. Crossover dribble to the foul line. He likes that shot. Pulls up and hits. He's a double figure.
Taylor very good off the dribble. Delaware's got to have a little bit better help on that. Without Tally, they're really short of long-range shooters. So Delaware can afford to take some chances in those gaps.
Lead back for UNCW, 25-23. We go under 8 minutes. First half of basketball. Mosley back in. Here's Walker. He'll try again from three. This time hitting. He's got room to bend, square, and fire. He's got beautiful form and gives Delaware the lead back for the first time since it was 4-3.
That was a great find by Mosley, reversing the court to Walker, who was by himself on that right side.
Estime on the other end goes back to UNCW to lead 27-26 as he got in close. Here's Daly taking it to the freshman, drawing contact, plus one for Ryan Daly. That'll bring us to a break with some energy. 7:22 left in the first half of the Hens back on top. It's 28-27.
Hi, I'm Matthew Kersey, owner of Chevrolet.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing. Maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously. Or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
Oh, say can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Back here in Newark, the Hens taking on UNCW for the second time in just 9 days. And we've got a close one just like it was in Wilmington, North Carolina. 28-27 is the count. Delaware on top after a bucket and a foul drawn by Ryan Daly. And Daly, you know, he's known for his scoring. And he's not necessarily a point guard listed on paper, but boy, can he handle that basketball.
Let's call him a point forward, Scott. I just love his skill level. It's underrated. His athleticism is underrated because he looks more like a linebacker out there, as we've already documented a number of times. What I like about him is he's smart enough and tough enough to play through contact, and that time he did. He's going to miss that foul shot. But with Daly attacking, and then that opens up his three-point shooting in his mid-range game, very difficult to defend.
Daly, one of three from the free throw line. He had made 10 of his last 11 after missing three consecutive free throws to end that UNCW game, but struggling a bit tonight. Delaware leads by one. This afternoon, I should say. Ball coming our way. Gary coming our way. I was ready to protect everybody. Don't worry.
I mean, you have the best hands here at the table.
Gary couldn't save it in a turnover. Just the second for UNCW as it goes back to the Hens with a one-point lead.
Well, this is huge from Delaware's perspective that both Talley and Kaycock are not getting minutes here. And UNCW switching to a little bit of zone themselves. They only play about zone 10% of the time.
Bryan at the free throw line. Into Carter. Carter turns, goes to his right hand. He loves that push shot from the middle of the paint, and he scores with it.
Good concept against the zone, a high-low. Darian Bryant to Carter, who used his footwork and his shot fake to make that jump hook.
Carter's got 7 points. Taylor forces one over Bryant. A good box out again by Carter, and he grabs the defensive rebound, his third board. Carter calling out to Mosley in our microphone, swing it, and they get it to Daly. Daly to the left side. He'll drive on the freshman over the seven-footer, shot off the mark. Rebound ricochets. His teammate travels out of bounds, but no, they're going to say he was bumped by Kyrie Walker before hitting the deck. So the freshman picks up his second, and that's his sixth on Delaware.
Ryan got caught about 2 feet further out than he wanted. He probably should have used one more quick glide dribble to get himself in a little closer to the basket, and that forced the miss. So that was better defense collapsing on Daly as he attacks. But when he does that, he's smart enough then. He'll reverse the ball, kick it out to a wide-open shooter, or play in the mid-range himself.
For the first time, we see Jackie Brown, the junior from a couple of community colleges before coming over and playing for C.B. McGrath, who had to take a couple transfers as Brown travels with the basketball to turn it over. Had to take a couple transfers because of the lack of a recruiting class. As I mentioned in the pregame show, 4 freshmen deciding not to honor their commitments after Kevin Keats went to NC State.
It's got to be a tough job for C.B. McGrath to replace all those scholarship players that left, and also the players that graduated last year. But he's tough. He coached at Kansas and at UNC. He'll get it right eventually.
30-27 the count as Walker's pass is knocked out of bounds. He's looking inside for Carter. 13 to shoot. We'll see Ryan Allen jump off the bench and check in. With 5:45 left in the first half, and Delaware up by 3. They led 4-0. That was their largest lead, and then UNCW built it up to an 8-point advantage. Now it's gone back and forth over the past several minutes. Mosley with the basketball off the inbound. Daly to the foul line and uses his physicality to get to the rim, just powering into the freshman Estime and getting the end one.
Well, Estime is kind of shrugging his shoulders and looking over the bench. Hey, you've got to beat Daly to the spot, which he did not do. Daly doing some really sophisticated things off the ball. He sets up the screening action really well. He makes hard cuts. And then once he catches it and he realizes he has the defender on his hip, he attacks immediately and draws the foul.
He's such a smart player as he makes the free throw. You're right. The sophistication of his game as only a sophomore to recognize mismatches is almost instantly. As Taylor goes to the rim, missing short, poked around into the hands of Darian Bryan. He wants to push. Delaware up by 6. Allen hesitates on the 3, gets it back to Bryan, and now Mosley will operate from the left wing. 23 seconds on the shot clock as he goes between his legs on a dribble. Mid-left block, it's Carter. Double team comes, pass is deflected by Bryan as he was trying to squeeze it in to Anthony Mosley. On the run is Taylor. Taylor, left side of his teammate, gets Bryant into the air. Drives, finds the trailer, Bryant. Bryant left elbow, back to Gary. He'll reset with 20 to shoot. And now it's Brown, who has a traveling violation, will pull up from 3 and a hit. How about that? Jockey Brown, just his 3rd 3-pointer of the season.
Boy, no fear. He did a good job because the scouting report on Brown is to sink underneath the ball screen. Smart players then will react, pull back, and shoot it as he did and made it.
He's only 2 of 8 so on 3s this season, so they got the scout right. He just happened to hit one. And now Delaware's lead is 3, 33-30. Daly gets it back up to 6.
Ryan called for the ball screen, and when he did, the defender immediately dropped off of him to sink underneath, and Daly recognized it with that subtlety of his offensive skill and knocks down the 3. But great preparation and intelligence on that play.
14 points in the first half for Ryan Daly as Delaware leads it 36-30. Taylor forces up a 3 and a rebound by Daly, who happens to also be our second leading rebounder on the team. Mosley on the drive, wraparound pass to Carter. Carter is fouled on his way up, and the Hens a chance to earn a couple more from the stripe.
To cool off Taylor, Delaware switched Darian Bryan onto him, and that length of Bryan and his quickness has really bothered Taylor in a couple of quick releases. Even though UNCW does not want to possess the ball as long as Delaware will to make them defend, Taylor has been affected by Darian Bryan's excellent defense.
Carter makes his first free throw, coming off of a 1 of 6 performance against William & Mary, a rarity as Carter has only shot under 60% in four of 13 games this season. That's really impressive. 60% is a really high percentage, and to have that type of streak going is a positive, as Carter will check out after making two. Sky Johnson back in the game with a bandage on his right elbow that I don't think I spotted.
It's probably just blood, Scott. I think that's what it was from the contact earlier on, but I like the fact that Coach Inglesby is trusting Sky Johnson more to get in for a couple rotations here in the first half. Tally back in. I'm amazed that Coach McGrath hasn't gone back to Tally and Kaycock because the game's getting away from him.
8-point lead for Delaware is their largest. The Seahawks' largest lead happens to be 8 as well. Gary missing a corner three and a chance to get a double-figure lead for the Hens. It's 5-on-4 as Bryant slow to get back. Darian Bryant lines up a corner three, and Delaware goes up 11.
The recognition of who was open by Mosley, and a great pass to Bryant, who was completely free in the left corner, and a really nice shot preparation by Bryant.
An 8-0 run by Delaware sends us to a break as C.B. McGrath has seen enough. He'll call a timeout with 3:42 left, and Delaware up 41-30 in the first.
Every day's a chance. A chance to flip the script. An invitation to take everything we know and reinvent it. It takes courage. It's an obsession. Never settling for just good enough. It takes a true creator to make something out of nothing. It takes guts. Calling all creators. Those who see obstacles as a chance to win bigger. Calling all creators. The game changers, the difference makers, the boundary breakers, the tomorrow takers. Calling all creators. Get up. Invent. Adapt. Write new rules. Calling all creators. It's a new day. Create something.
Be your one-stop shop for everything winter. Stock up on favorite soups, hot beverages, and ingredients for your favorite meals like Lancaster brand meats. And don't forget the firewood. Acme, the official supermarket of the Philadelphia Eagles, will play their playoff game next week to start things off. And Darian Bryant, as he went to break, made a three-point shot. He has made double figures in three of his last seven games, got square on that shot and knocked it through.
When Darian Bryant gets his feet set and bends his knees, he is a very effective shooter. At times, he gets a little rushed in his shot if he's guarded by a taller player, but there is great preparation. But what I love about Darian, no matter what's going on with his offense, his defense always stays solid.
It's a bonus when he scores for Delaware as Tally tries to get it into Bryant. Last touch by Tally, a rare turnover for the point guard. And you're absolutely right. Whatever he does offensively for the Hens, that's extra. He's there to play defense as he is now tasked with guarding their point guard, Jordan Tally, who's 0-3 in this game and has a turnover there. It's Allen, long range three to add to Delaware's total.
Well, Ryan Allen, for a freshman, was really intelligent there. He lost his defensive assignment on the screen, Jeff Gary, and he knew he was wide open, rose right up into the shot.
Elbow jump shot on the other side, and Tally's on the board with a jump shot, making the score 44-32, Delaware's lead, 3 minutes left in the first.
Tally loves to probe, and then he'll pull out. That time he attacked, got into the mid-range, and made the jump.
Allen in rhythm, missing that time from the right, and Brown, the smallest player on the floor, with a long rebound as he brings it up for the Seahawks. Bryant with one dribble and a pass to Jordan Tally, who leads the team with nearly six assists per game. He penetrates in close, can't get enough on the shot as he's fouled, but he'll go to the stripe where he shoots a team-high 83%.
It almost looks like Jordan Talley's gotten his legs back. He looks much quicker out on the court than he did in his first rotation before he was taken out for the two fouls. He's good with his right and his left. He can get almost anywhere he wants. Bryant is doing a good job with him, but can't quite level him out enough to keep him out of that deep lane area.
Tally, a big contributor last year coming off the bench for UNCW on their championship team. So much talent on that squad. He had 16 points off the bench against Delaware in the CAA tournament. down in Charleston last season. Misses the first, makes the second. An 11-point lead for Delaware, 44-33.
What Jordan Talley, as a senior, has done, he recognizes that they need his offense right now in becoming the leader. He did try a pass inside, but he had poor angle. But he's now going to be very assertive offensively.
Sky Johnson banging in to Marcus Bryant. Bryant timed it out well. And Sky Johnson, a guy that hasn't played a whole lot of minutes and not had a lot of post touches, needs to recognize that Bryant was just timing it up to take that charge.
And he was. But once you make the first contact, you know the defender's going to stay high. Immediately drop step to the baseline, and you're going to be wide open for a step under.
Inbound, in the paint it goes, as there's a foul now called on the other end against Sky Johnson. His second, it'll send the Seahawks to line for a 1-1.
Well, Sky is giving us really good minutes. Even though he made that mistake down there and missed that jump hook, he's being more assertive. He's trying to help the team out offensively, as well as his defense, his physicality, his rebounding. I like the fact that he's feeling more comfortable and confident to do that.
Talley makes the first, the front end of the 1-1. Jordan Talley, one of the all-time winningest players at UNCW, needs 10 more wins to become the winningest player in UNCW history. If he does so, he'll catch Brett Blizzard and Craig Callahan. And those are some stars from back in the day winning some championships at UNCW. Two free throws good and a timeout taken by Martin Inglesby. We'll stay right here as the Hens can't take the timeout into the second half. So still 2:22 remaining in this first half. I want to remind our listeners that a portion of this broadcast presented by First State Orthopedics, the team taking care of Delaware. Visit firststateortho.com. And Delaware made some good adjustments in this first half, Bill. They trailed by as many as 8. UNCW really had some flow. And the game changed when Devontae Kaycock picked up his second foul.
It certainly did. I thought the shift from the zone, which we opened in, a little unusual for us, 1-2-2. They bounce 3 wide-open three-pointers. We go back to man. We start defending him better. And then with Ryan Daly finding those angles, as we talked about, attacking the basket, I think we slowed down the tempo a little bit, did not allow UNCW to get in rhythm offensively anymore, and that was really the big changeup. Plus, we're going through the post as best we can.
Want to get that lead to as big as you can, because you know the big guy Kaycock will be playing in this second half of basketball. He is a difference maker. A 9-point lead for Delaware, 44-35. 10 to shoot as Daly off the timeout has it on Jalen Forns. A crossover dribble behind the back now for Daly. Picks it up. 5 seconds for Mosley. Mosley, top of the key, 2-point shot off the mark. That's not what Delaware wanted. Off the timeout, Talley quickly down the floor to Forns. Extra pass, Gary. Corner three for the freshman. Off the mark, rebounded by Anthony Mosley. He is so tough grabbing boards as a point guard is for today.
Anthony's got great anticipation, great athleticism, but what I really like is he times out those jumps perfectly and outfights opponents.
Bright with a pass to Ryan Allen, who has 9 points for the Hens this first half. Carter, double team, dribbles once, back out towards the three-point arc. We'll hand it off to Mosley. 7 to shoot for Champ. He's got 5, beyond the arc with 4. Now drives with 3. Tough angle, draws the foul. No, an offensive charge. Going to be called against Anthony Mosley, and Delaware stuck late in the shot clock on back-to-back possession.
And they get stuck down on the baseline, which really gives the defensive team that extra defender down there. They've got to withdraw the ball and attack from the middle of the lane and not along the baseline. Anthony's a little too veteran a player to get caught in that position, but a tough play, and I give Brown some credit. He stood his ground in there and took the forearm.
Rare turnover for Anthony Mosley, who does a nice job taking care of the basketball for the Hens. 44-35, 60 seconds left in the first half as Talley hesitates, pulls up on the right side and hits. He's getting into a flow offensively now with 7 since returning into the game.
Better offense than pretty good defense there by Brian. Talley does like to work to his right side for his jump shot, but his leap really allowed him to elevate over top of Darian Bryant, who had a good high hand contest.
Talley missed his first 3 shots. He's made his last 2. Delaware up 44-37. Daly at the foul line, back to Allen straight away. Freshman on freshman matchup as Gary defends. Allen brings it to the left side. Crossover to the freshman from DeMatha. Going to work. Fadeaway jump shot. Baseline is smooth.
Tough, tough shot with the fadeaway, as you mentioned. A little step back created the space. And I want to talk about, when we get a chance, the shot clock priority here that happens late in these halves and of this game with the players not able to recognize it.
10 seconds for UNCW until we end the first half. Ends up 46-37. 5 seconds for Talley. Right side. 3 seconds. Talley contested jump shot. That's just better offense. Solid defense by Darian Bryant, but Talley got hot to end the first half, and Delaware's lead only 6. It was up to 14 at the 3:25 mark, but UNCW, with the help of Jordan Talley, who has 10 first-half points, makes it a 46-40 lead at the break.
Talley just made a couple great individual plays there. It wasn't the fault of the defense. They're forcing him where they want. Maybe what we'll do is do a little bit more denial and try to keep the ball out of Talley's hands once he brings it across and gives it up. Maybe some face guarding might help.
Hens, the advantage over UNCW. Ryan Daly with 14. Ryan Allen with 11. Eric Carter with 9 after 20 minutes of action.
New Year's resolution, Sue?
I'm getting the whole house organized. And the sales saved me hundreds. You?
Started with the garage. But these are gonna be great.
Yeah.
visit your GMC dealer and get something you really want. Get 18% below MSRP on the most popular remaining 2017 GMC Acadia models. That's over $9,100 below MSRP on a GMC Acadia Denali. We are professional grade. GMC.
Do you want to know how to avoid the return line this year? Just ask for gifts you won't want to return. Well, I am not going to need this receipt.
Ring in the new year at your Buick dealer. Experience the new Buick and get 18% below MSRP on almost every remaining 2017 Envision model. That's over 7,500 on this Buick Envision Essence.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert,
at the mall,
on the mountain,
at school,
at the beach,
in the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing. Maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously. Or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
Every day's a chance. A chance to flip the script. An invitation to take everything we know and reinvent it. It takes courage. It's an obsession. Never settling for just good enough. It takes a true creator to make something out of nothing. It takes guts. Calling all creators. Those who see obstacles as a chance to win bigger. Calling all creators. The game changers. The difference makers. The boundary breakers. The tomorrow takers. Calling all creators. Get up. Invent. Adapt. Write new rules. Calling all creators. It's a new day. Create something.
America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
New Year's resolution, Sue?
I'm getting the whole house organized. And the sales saved me hundreds. You?
Started with the garage. These are gonna be great.
Yeah.
Visit your GMC dealer and get something you really want. Get 18% below MSRP on the most popular remaining 2017 GMC Acadia models. That's over $9,100 below MSRP on a GMC Acadia Denali. We are professional grade. GMC.
Do you wanna know how to avoid the return line this year? Just ask for gifts you won't wanna return. Well, I am not going to need this receipt.
Ring in the new year at your Buick dealer. Experience the new Buick and get 18% below MSRP on almost every remaining 2017 Envision model. That's over 7,500 on this Buick Envision Essence.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart. Moving forward.
Who is 5 of 6 from the free throw line, also 3 rebounds for Carter. Mosley with 6, 3 points for Walker, 3 points for Darian Bryant. Taylor has 11, 10 for Jordan Talley on the other side for UNCW. Forge with 8, Kaycock with 6 points, 4 rebounds in just 10 minutes because of those 2 fouls. 3 points for Brown, 2 for Estime. Looking at the rebounding difference, Delaware out-rebounding UNCW 16-14. 3 offensive rebounds for both squads. Delaware with 6 assists on 15 makes. 5 turnovers for Delaware, 4 assists for UNCW, 4 turnovers for the Seahawks. Delaware shooting 57% from the field, 50% from 3, and 79% from the free throw line. UNCW 45% from the field, 5 of 12, 42% from 3, and 90%, 9 of 10 from the free throw line.
We wanted to talk about that shot clock situation. Now that the bench is in front of the offense to manage the shot clock, since it's no longer at the top of the basket, it's on the side, the team and the coaches can then call out the time. They'll probably start it about 7 seconds down, so a big advantage of having, and it'll be the same for UNCW, having the bench in front of the offense here with the shot clocks not at the top of the basket.
21 seconds till we begin the second half of basketball. UNCW, the back-to-back defending CAA champions. A new head coach this year as Kevin Keats moved on to NC State. Big win for NC State last night over Duke. C.B. McGrath knows a thing or two about Duke basketball and NC State basketball as he comes from that area. 14 seasons on the UNC staff, 11 as assistant, and 3 as an ops director, and of course won that national championship. All the assistants on UNCW from the Tar Heels, Doug Eslick, graduate in 05. Jackie Manuel, an 05 graduate. And Joe Wolf, UNC class of 87, spent some time in the NBA himself.
McGrath was the team captain of Kansas and then went on to assist there, as you mentioned. I really was impressed with that he's followed the coaching around and bringing the UNC staff to it.
We are underway here in the second half as they start where they left off in that first half. Inside to Ryan Daly from the left block, and he draws contact and the foul. That's a third and one Ryan Daly has gotten today. He had that and one that gave Delaware the lead late against UNCW on the road, and starts the second half with his 16th point.
With a 2-inch and a 20-pound advantage over Forns, and he posts up low, he's going to be able to score an awful lot. So a good job by Delaware coming out of the halftime and running a set play to get Ryan Daly such a good look.
Daly's got to get a little bit more consistency from that free throw line. 2 of 5 today as he can't complete the old-fashioned three-point play. Talia pass inside to Kaycock is deflected. Out of bounds it goes. It'll stay with the Seahawks. 15 to shoot.
Don't like to talk about stats too much, but Kaycock with no offensive rebounds in the first half. He had 8 in the game down at Trask.
Inbound. Deflected into Kaycock. Johnny on the spot from the right block. Gets 2 easy ones.
Well, the deflection goes to Kaycock, who did a really nice job of securing that, keeping the ball high, and just shooting that little right-hand jump hook off his left shoulder over Eric Carter.
Daly attacking again, left to right, and scoring 18 points for the sophomore.
He lost Forns with some really good off-the-ball movement.
Talley crossed the court. A quick 3 from Taylor, and he was open. 14 points for the transfer from Wichita State.
Taylor spotted up in the left corner. Walker slow to get out to access him, but what he's got to do is get a high hand up. There was absolutely no contest, so Taylor had a wide-open look at the basket.
5-point lead for Delaware, 50 to 45. Daly, a 3, hand in the face, not enough to stop him. The 7th 20-point game of the season. Ryan Daly.
Well, Forens fortunately did not make Ryan Daly uncomfortable at all. When he feels in rhythm, he can rise up over the shorter player.
21 points for the sophomore from Archbishop Carroll. Kaycock fouled. He'll go to the free throw line after missing on the hook in the paint.
Coach Inglesby's trying to get that push off by Kaycock, but he's not going to be able to talk the officials into changing their call. But what Eric's got to do is slide a little further to that left shoulder and force Kaycock to drop step and work back to his right.
Kaycock bends the knees. He went 2 of 2, now 3 of 3. We talked about not a very good free throw shooter on average, 62%. But he's 3 of 3 today, making that one. As Forns will go to the bench. And we see Estime check in, the freshman Estime from Georgia, the first player to sign with C.B. McGrath at UNCW. He'll be a good one. Kaycock 4-4 from the stripe, and it's 53-47. A lead for Delaware as Mosley brings it up the floor.
Estime, a little bit better defender, may play Ryan Daly when they play man, but they've switched back to a little 2-3 zone.
Carter, one dribble, and a pass to Ryan Allen. Ball fake. Walker playing with 3 fouls, drives baseline, stops himself on top to Daly. He'll drive right side to the cup. Kaycock too late to stop Ryan Daly, who has 23.
Ryan Daly's got a great feel for when to release that shot off the glass.
Talley thought about a 3, steps in. Long 2 is good. He stays hot as Talley now with 12, all coming from the 3:30 mark in the first half to 2 minutes in right now.
Delaware's got to do something different in their defensive assignment to play Talley, who's in wonderful rhythm here, and he just has a unique feel for getting open off the dribble.
Inside to Carter. Bounce pass to Cutter is Mosley. Beautiful look from the block by Eric Carter.
The weak side cut with a adequate post passer, which Eric Carter is a really good way to beat the zone, and a nice flash there by Anthony Mosley.
57-49, Delaware's lead, 17-30, second half. Bryan with a ball fake and a handoff to Taylor. Taylor's been in good rhythm today after struggling against Delaware at Trask Coliseum. Talley thought about the shot, could close out by Mosley, prevents it. 10 to shoot for Estime. Inside to Kaycock, right block, loses grip, gets it back. Fades too strong off the right side of the rim into the hands of Ryan Daly. Daly's 3rd rebound in 20 minutes of action. Lobs it across the court to Allen. Allen in rhythm, a 3 is good. Touching nothing but the net.
Ryan Allen did a great job, Scott, of sprinting the court. He went left and then crossed back over to the right and got himself perfectly square, and a really well-delivered pass by Ryan Daly to find Allen in that deep right corner.
Ryan Allen, multiple three-pointers made in 11 of 14 games this season for the freshman. Talley fades, elbow right, nothing stopping the senior from Virginia.
He's using the ball screen extremely well.
Carter running the floor. Kaycock picks up his third, and Carter will go to the free throw line.
Well, Kaycock made a bad mistake there. He didn't quite hustle back because he was involved in the ball screen action, which freed Talley up at the other end for that mid-range shot. Eric Carter runs rim to rim to sprint, and then Kaycock just got elevated trying to block Carter's shot. A little head and shoulders fake by Eric does the job on Kaycock.
That's a big foul, his third, as Carter will go to the free throw line where he is 5 of 6 in this contest, 5 of 7 after that miss. And Kaycock, who leads the nation in rebounds, pulls that one. Daly sprinting back and getting a steal as Talley sent it across the court. 19th steal on the season for Ryan Daly, second most to Anthony Mosley. Here's Daly, gets a screen from Carter. Carter slips, pass across court to Walker, an open look at another three. His second make today. First time in his young career, he's made multiple three-pointers.
And UNCW, CB McGrath will call a timeout. A really nice job of Delaware sharing the ball against this zone, reversing it, and then getting wide open looks.
We'll take a break with C.B. McGrath and his Seahawks. Delaware back up 14 for the second time this afternoon. We'll be back in a moment on 94.7 WDSD.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
On a tear to open up the second half, shooting 8 of 8 from the field, 3 of those from distance as Daly, Allen, and now Kyrie Walker, the latest to get involved from beyond the arc. And Kyrie Walker is going to be a heck of a defender. We already know he can leap to the rim, but if he develops that 3-point shot, teams are going to be in trouble.
He's got a really good looking technique to his shot. Gets his elbow high, has excellent rotation on the ball. What I like about him is now, as he gets comfortable and confident, he's shot preparing even better with his knees bent, ready to go right up into the shot. A great job by Kyrie Walker, getting better as the season's going on.
65-51 after the timeout by C.B. McGrath, approaching the 16-minute mark. So we'll take another break after the next whistle for the media timeout. It's D.M.A. from the corner to Taylor. Bounce pass to Talley, 8 to shoot. Bryant, baseline, wraparound pass, corner, Esteme the 3, quickly up and off the mark into the hands of a heck of a rebounder himself, Eric Carter, against the nation's leading rebounder in Kaycock. Mosley all the way down the floor. He's stripped. No contact, they'll say it was clean, from Ty Taylor, who gets his 13th steal of the season in the corner. Esteme missed from the left side, won't try from the right. Hesitation dribble back to Taylor. He'll operate, guarded by Mosley. Pass right, block to Bryant. Has some weight and height on Kyrie Walker. Can't finish, but no box out on the freshman Esteme. He tips it up and in.
Esteme is very quick and athletic, and that was part of the scouting report. Make sure he and others, Taylor and Talley, are blocked out because they're very effective offensive rebounder for guards.
Mosley to Kyrie Walker. Walker having a good day with 6 points, all from beyond the arc. Allen, the freshman, inside to Carter. What a look!
Weak side pick and roll. They lift Ryan Daly out of the corner to clear the help. And because he's been so effective, the defender stays with him. That provides Eric Carter a wide open path to the basket. A really nice find by Ryan Allen with a left-handed pass.
Carter's got 13, and Delaware's lead is 67-53. Talley bounce to Kaycock. Strong take by the versatile big man to get two right back.
The same play at the other end, except they cleared the backside out, so it was a weak side pick and roll. There's no help there. Delaware's got to have a defender rotate across and get in Kaycock's path.
Kaycock up to 12 points. He only had 7 down in Wilmington, North Carolina, away from the ball. A foul called against Jay Esteme will send us to a break. 14:27 left, and Delaware on top by 12. It's 67-55 here at the bottom.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Fans, a chance to double up on basketball promotions tomorrow. Every time the Hens win the next night at Klondike Kate's, you get 20% off your dinner by sharing the social media graphic or bringing in your ticket stub. And there's a coaches show tomorrow night at Klondike Kate's. 7 o'clock, join myself, head coach Martin Inglesby, Natasha Adair of the women's basketball squad, and Matt Janis. We'll have some fun and a great meal at Klondike Kate's tomorrow on Monday night. At Klondike Kate's, as we get back in action here, lob pass inside, looking for Eric Carter, and a foul called, the third on Jay Estime on the reach in.
Darian Bryant, the inbounder, realized that Eric Carter had a mismatch on him and dropped the ball off and was fouled on the floor, but a good job by Bryant operating as the inbounder.
Carter was pleading that he was on the way up for a shot, didn't get it, so instead it goes to Ryan Allen. We'll take three instead of a possible two from the free throw line.
Ryan Allen, when he gets his feet set, is as good a standstill shooter as there is in the conference.
Inside, it goes to Kaycox and bumps, and a foul going to be called against Eric Carter. That's his third, so Carter's got three. Walker three, Johnson three. That's for Delaware. Three for Estime, Kaycox, Forns, and Tally. Excuse me, Tally only with the two for UNCW.
Eric Carter lost track of where Kaycock was. Kaycock cut underneath of him, and then Eric's only retort was to bump him with his body. He's just got to lay off of him there. We need Eric to play more minutes.
Kaycock driving, and quickly another reach-in foul. If that's on Sky, which it is, that's his fourth. So Delaware, as we've noted all season long, without bodies. Jacob Cushing out for probably another week at least. Kevin Anderson not available, and Derek Woods dismissed from the team earlier this season. Only seven guys, and as we get 14 minutes left, that's a lot of basketball to play with guys in foul trouble.
And that's what I was worried about with the foul by Carter and that one by Sky Johnson. Not only are we short, we may have to go real short, and that gives Kaycock a big advantage on the glass.
Off the inbound, a miss from three. Bryan offensive board, and with the short lineup for Delaware, another rebound by Bryan. Kick out the Tally, a miss on the three. It's tipped, and Delaware has it secured. Small lineup on the court for the Hens. Mosley, Bryant, Walker, Daly, and Allen. And they'll send it on top to Daly. Daly to Allen, a jab step. Pulls up, elbow, jump shot two. He liked it, but it spun out. And a 15-point lead it stays for Delaware. Tally, pound of the court as he gets it up to the floor. A wide open look for Gary. He misses. Kaycock dominant underneath the offensive glass. He gets fouled, and that's now the fourth on Kyrie Walker.
And that's really the problem I was worried about. Kaycock now is going to have his way inside. Delaware's got to find someone that's willing to block him out at all times. But at the other end, even though that's a really good look by Ryan Allen, and I'm not going to question the fact that it was a good or a bad shot, I think sometimes, especially with UNCW, who's not good at the end of possessions with their defense, let's run a little bit more clock, share the ball a little bit more with a 15-point lead to shorten the game up a little bit.
Kaycock misses on the free throw. 4 of 5 today, 7 rebounds for Kaycock, who averages 13.1 rebounds per game, leads the nation in that category. Jordan Murphy of Minnesota, second at 12.7.
And a nice substitution here, Scott, by Martin to bring back Eric Carter and let him play with three. He needs to be in there battling against Kaycock.
Kaycock makes his second, so Carter replaces Kyrie Walker, sitting next to Torian Jones on the bench. Is Sky Johnson with four and Walker with four. Mosley going to take some time. There is a lot of basketball left in this one. 13-25. left from the Bob Carpenter Center. It goes to Allen in the corner. Another jump shot, baseline this time off the mark. Rebounded into the hands of Kaycock after a tip from his teammate, Estime. Tally up the floor, high dribbles with the right hand. Uses the screen to bring him to the left side. Backdoor goes to Estime, into Carter. Carter trying at all costs to avoid picking up that fourth, but just could not get out of the way. And he picks up that fourth foul.
Well, nice backdoor and a good recognition there to attack Eric Carter. But I thought he had backed off enough not to get. That's what we call one of those touch fouls that when you're a key player in a big moment of the game, just back away and let the guy score. Don't even go over and contest it, because 2 points at this juncture of the game is not nearly as important as you maintaining your presence in the game.
Stime finishes off the three-point play, lead down to 11 for the Hens. Added as many as 15 just about a minute ago.
This may be a game of attrition to see who's left here at the end.
Mosley at the foul line. Corner, Bryant thought about the three. Good closeout by the freshman, Gary. Back on top to another freshman, Allen, as he swings it to the senior captain. Here's Champ operating with the left side. 10 to shoot. Allen gets in shooting position. Inside, it's Johnson. Johnson flips to Mosley. Mosley can't get enough to get the ball up and over the rim, but he is fouled, and two free throws coming Champ's way. An opportunity for him to get in double figures.
Champ Mosley does a great job of recognizing when the defense turns their heads. The ball goes to the post. Most people take a look in there just to see what the post activity is going to be. He back cuts immediately Sky Johnson with a nice little underhand pass to get the ball to Mosley from that weak side. That's the best place to cut against man-to-man, from that backside elbow position when the ball is down on the opposite low post.
Mosley misses the free throw. He's 4 of 5 today. 7 assists, only 1 turnover for Champ Mosley, tying his career high in assists. He's done it 3 other times, most recently against Cornell. Makes his second, up to Taylor, the lead 71-59, 12:39 to play. Gary, corner, Estime, he's not shy, lets it fly, and a miss, tapped out by Mosley. He wants to run across half court, eyes up the floor, stops at the top of the key. Corner goes to Daly, enough room to fire a three, missing into the hands of UNCW, tracked down along the sideline, and here comes Tally the other way for the Seahawks. With position, Kaycock slicing inside, Tally, shot blocked into Kaycock. Kaycock misses, follows his shot, and the second try is good for the junior from Georgia.
Kaycock has great tenacity, great activity, and a motor that never stops. He stayed with that rebound. When you're defending a post player who shoots a short shot, you have to immediately turn and block him out.
Johnson could have fouled out on that last possession as well. There was a little bit of contact. Delaware lucked out, no whistle. 71-61 the lead for the Hens. Bryant drops it to Johnson. Johnson to the rim, and that'll do it for Sky Johnson. Ran right into Jay Estime. That was close to where the arc, the circle was, but they call the offensive foul against Sky Johnson, and Delaware will take a 10-point lead into a timeout. 11:49 to play at the Bob Carpenter Center.
This is what it sounds
like. Reverse that. I'll clean it up on the other.
Every day is a chance. A chance to flip the script. An invitation to take everything we know and reinvent it. It takes courage. It's an obsession. Never settling for just good enough. It takes a true creator to make something out of nothing. It takes guts. Calling all creators. Those who see obstacles as a chance to win bigger. Calling all creators. The game changers, the difference makers, the boundary breakers, the tomorrow takers. Calling all creators. Get up. Invent. Adapt. Write new rules. Calling all creators. It's a new day. Create something.
SD and iHeartRadio.
Back here at the Bob Carpenter Center, where there is just too much time left on this second half clock to feel comfortable with a 10-point lead. Hens up 71-61, but Sky Johnson has just fouled out of the game on a call that was bang-bang underneath, an offensive foul. I thought Estime, as did you, Bill, was underneath that arced area, but it's UNCW basketball after Johnson fouls out in 6 minutes. Eric Carter has 4 fouls. Kyrie Walker has 4 fouls. And a reminder to our listeners, Jacob Cushing out with an injury. Kevin Anderson out with an injury. Derek Woods dismissed from the team a couple weeks back. So you've got seven scholarship guys on this team. If three guys foul out for Delaware, you're looking at extended minutes for Lochner or Rufo down the stretch of this basketball game. So the Hens with Johnson and Carter on their bench back out on the floor with a very small lineup against the best rebounder in the country.
And Delaware will play some zone here to protect this foul situation.
Haycock right at Daly, a miss. Mosley saves it. Luckily, it was just away from the outstretched arms of Devontae Haycock, who if he snared it would have had a dunk. Instead, Bryant has it now for Delaware. Kyrie Walker against the zone. Bryant wide open for a three, and he hits it.
Well, great recognition by Delaware. UNCW switched to a box and one, and that left him wide open up there. They reversed the ball due to the flatness of the zone. They were face guarding Ryan Allen in front of our bench.
Bryant has made two threes. He's got 6 points. Bryant, a slow start to the year, averaging about 3 points per game in the first seven. Now up to closer to eight over his last seven. A miss. Haycock offensive board. Daly took it away from him. What an effort by Ryan Daly, knocking the ball out of the hands of Devontae Haycock. Not an easy task to do.
Tough guy play there by Ryan Daly, because Haycock has big and excellent hands. They're very soft, and he gets usually secures every ball he gets his hand on.
Mosley penetrates against Gary, finds a way to the rim, and Mosley's got 11 in double figures, the fourth player to get there for the Hens. On the other end, Taylor into Walker. He's done. Delaware has no bench left in terms of scholarship players after that foul by Walker. He's got to be just smarter than that.
You just have to step away. Unless you have committed to draw the charge, which he had not, just step away and let the basket happen. Right now, with the lead, that's the smartest thing to do, because we need players on the court. What I was going to mention earlier on, when Mosley attacked Gary, that was a senior versus a rookie. I just really liked his body control. He goes right into the chest of the shot blocker and can score on just about anybody his size at the basket.
Connor Rufo will come in, the walk-on from the Samford school, as Taylor misses the free throw. And, you know, Connor Rufo, I remember watching him play at Samford when Samford was down at Slam Dunk at the Beach against La Lumiere, the number one team in the country. And Samford took him to overtime. Rufo, I remember playing tough, boxing out in that game against guys that are going to be in the NBA one day. He is not afraid of the challenge, and he'll have to give some minutes now for the Hens, up 76-62 with 10:22 left. And no scholarship players available anymore for the Hens on the bench. Here's Bryant, dribble drive right into Bryant, draws contact, plus one. That's a big take by Darian Bryant, who has made some stellar clutch plays in his time with the Hens already.
Marcus Bryant is just not mobile enough to be playing that close to Darian Bryant that far out on the perimeter, and a really nice recognition by Darian Bryant to just take the taller player off the dribble into the basket. Bad play there by Bryant, just in terms of his alignment against Bryant. And what I was going to say about Connor Rufo, a very smart and tough player. He's got more skill than people would know.
Taylor a three, rattles out, no box out on Forns, tips it to Bryant. He was fouled. That looked all ball, but a whistle going to go against Connor Rufo. And if anybody's going to get the foul called, he's got four more. But I thought that was a solid defensive effort. It'll send Bryant to the free throw line, as Darian Bryant made the free throw on the other end, extending the lead back up to 79-62.
Well, not a bad foul in the sense that Marcus Bryant is not a particularly good free throw shooter. And Connor Rufo has five fouls to give.
Bryant does miss the first free throw, just 50% on the season. The senior transfer from UNC Charlotte. He's played well against Delaware. Last season, a season high 7 against the Hens. This year, season high 11 on December 30th. And he makes his second free throw, his first point of this contest. Delaware leads it by 16. And we are halfway through the second half. Hens playing with four scholarship players and a walk-on in Connor Rufo from Samford School. Stan Waterman proud right now. He's got two Warriors on the court. Rufo dribbling right side. Up and under move, going for his shot. He's fouled. He draws contact against Marcus Bryant. And a smile on the face of Bill Phillips and Martin Inglesby as they see the youngster trying to work for his own shot.
And a big smile on Anthony Mosley. his old teammate at Sanford, really encouraging Connor Rufo. Really a great young man, a terrific student. But what I liked about him when he played for Sanford, Scott, was how hard he competed all the time. And he drew some tough assignments due to the competition level that Sanford played.
And he makes the first free throw. He's 3 of 3 from the free throw line this season. And Rufo in a position that we saw last couple seasons with Curtis McCroy, a walk-on that due to injuries and lack of scholarships really earned a spot. He was a starter at some point for Delaware. As Rufo misses his second free throw, but Mosley tracks down the offensive board. Delaware, a reset. This is their largest lead, so despite all the foul trouble that we've been talking about, let's not get lost. So Delaware up by 17. It is their largest lead of the contest, and now just 9:26 left to play. Mosley to the rim, gets enough spin on it off the window, and the Hens lead by 19 points here at home. Talley quickly a jump shot, gets two right back.
Boy, Talley is as quick and fast as any player in the league with the ball, just attacking immediately into the mid-range. And let's remember, Kaycock is out. He just came back in, so we were able to benefit from him being out for a couple minutes.
Allen spinning on Taylor, baseline left, tries to draw contact. It's blocked out of bounds. Last touch by Devontae Kaycock, who got his hand on it.
Well, Kaycock pretty aggressive there. I thought he could have just gone straight up, but he left his feet and almost drew that fourth foul, which would be crucial.
Estime will check out. We see Jackie Brown back in, the junior from North Carolina. Bryant will inbound, left side to Daly. Daly's got 23 points, 16 first half points. A good shooting day for Daly, 9 of 14 from the floor. Allen inside to Daly. Daly spinning to his left. Strong back iron tipped by Devontae Kaycock to himself, and now Talley on the run. Loses grip on a bounce pass. Daly didn't need to touch it. He didn't need to go for it. He knew it. Daly was trying to reach for it to get a breakaway transition basket. It would have been out of bounds. Last touch by Taylor. And Daly just did not grip it, so it stays with the Seahawks.
That's what aggressive players do, though. He was trying to steal it so he could go down and attack with numbers at Delaware's advantage. Just one of those reaction plays.
He knew it as soon as he touched the basketball. So it stays with the Seahawks. Driving is Forns. Forns along the baseline, passes to Taylor. Taylor in close, gets a layup. Four straight for the Seahawks, and it's 82-67, 8:24 to play.
Well, they tried to attack through Connor Rufo on the baseline. He did a good job of shutting it off, so showing that he can defend as well as get to the free throw line.
Bryant over to Daly. Daly in the corner, guarded by Forns. Takes him baseline. Daly double teamed and a whistle, as there's a foul on the floor, and Daly again doing a nice job of recognizing. Forrence has had trouble sticking with Ryan Daly throughout today, so he attacks him and draws the contact. That's the eighth against the Seahawks and the fourth against Jalen Forrence, so Daly will shoot the 1-1.
Who knows how many players will be left on the court of the starters by the end of this game. Ryan Daly is just so tough-minded along that baseline. If he gets just a little bit of an advantage, he's going.
Nobody knew it was a 1-on-1 except for Ryan Daly. He missed the front end, got his own rebound, and put it up and through.
That's the second time that UNCW has failed to block out on a defensive foul shot situation. Sky Johnson had a rebound early in the game. That time Daly does, and Kaycock could not attack.
That's just terrible recognition by the Seahawks. They do recognize on the other end the mismatch that Kaycock has underneath. They feed him, and he scores with 7:45 left to go. And Delaware's lead 84-69.
And Eric Carter getting up to come back in to provide a little bit more defense inside, not forcing Ryan Daly to guard the much larger Kaycock.
Mosley straight away. He's got 13 points to the foul line. He goes on top to Daly. Daly calling for a screen, 11 to shoot. Bryant sets it. Daly comes around the screen. Top of the key three from Daly is short into the hands of Taylor. UNCW wants to push, trying to cut into this lead as quickly as they possibly can. Taylor a lob inside to Kaycock. He is hammered in close. Daly, Rufo, and Allen all there. And the foul will go against Connor Rufo, his second. Delaware will take a break with 7:16 to go. And Delaware up 84-69 over UNCW.
New Year's resolution, Sue?
I'm getting the whole house organized. And the sales saved me hundreds. You?
Started with the garage. But these are going to be great.
Yeah.
Visit your GMC dealer and get something you really want. Get 18% below MSRP on the most popular remaining 2017 GMC Acadia models. That's over $9,100 below MSRP on a GMC Acadia Denali. We are professional grade. GMC.
Do you want to know how to avoid the return line this year? Just ask for gifts you won't want to return. Well, I'm not going to need this receipt.
Ring in the new year at your Buick dealer. Experience the new Buick and get 18% below MSRP on almost every remaining 2017 Envision model. That's over 7,500 on this Buick Envision Essence.
Bill Harmon, Benny Pinnell producing back in the studio on your home for Blue Hen Sports, 94.7 WDSD-FM. And the Hens just trying to keep this lead with 7:16 to go. And two players fouled out on a team that only has seven scholarship players. Connor Rufo doing a great job of coming in and spelling Eric Carter for a few minutes. And we'll see Eric Carter back in the game as we resume action. Devontae Kaycock on a lot.
Connor gave Coach Inglesby some great minutes in there. He knows exactly what his role is, and he fulfills it. He plays good defense. He's tough, and he went in and drew a foul and got to the foul line and made one of two.
Kaycock misses the first of two. Second foul was called on Rufo as we went to break. Connor, 6'3", 190 from Hocasin, Delaware. We'll probably see him again at some point if Eric Carter needs a breather. Kaycock makes the second. We'll see his teammate check back in for Brown. It's 84-70, 7:16 remain. Delaware's led by as many as 19 points. That coming 2 minutes ago.
A little bit of pressure here by UNCW, which is not what they're known for, whereas in the past they did a lot of full court pressure. They may play a little bit of extended zone to protect Kaycock.
A whistle, and it'll go against Gary, and Daly, out of frustration, pounded the floor with the basketball. I thought I heard an extra whistle for possibly a technical foul, but instead it'll be Daly at the free throw line. Still a 1-on-1. Last time, Daly missed the front end. No one on UNCW realized it was a 1-on-1, and Daly was able to get the rebound and the putback. She'll be well aware this time with C.B. McGrath letting them know.
Foul shot block out is really important, and a lot of teams don't practice it very much, and Delaware's taking advantage of that tonight, this afternoon.
Daly, though, not taking advantage of his trips to line. 2 of 7 today from the stripe. A lob pass to Kaycock off the mark. He tried to tip it in, falling out of bounds, but it was too short. And the Hens with the basketball up 14, 6:50 left. Mosey brings it to the right side, 20 to shoot. Allen to Daly. Daly with 25 points, his seventh 20-point performance of the season. Back-to-back 20-point performances as Allen drives into Kaycock. Somehow gets it up off his hip and in.
Ryan Allen did a terrific job of using the screen. You teach players to go shoulder to shoulder, hip to hip. He did that, and that's what created the rub and the advantage to attack Kaycock, who had to back off of it.
Allen's got 19. Kaycock slow to get up, and he'll shake it off. He is limping, wincing a bit. I don't see a player coming off the bench for UNCW, so Kaycock looks like he's going to stay in the game, but he is leaning over with his hands on his knees in pain, just trying to walk it off as he jogs up the court. Talley will pick it up near half court and operate the offense for the Seahawks. Corner goes to Steeme. A ball fake on Carter, playing with those four fouls. Talley, long range three, off balance. Did get square. Tipped into the hands of Anthony Mosley, and the Hens can work some more clock.
I know UNCW loves to shoot it quickly, but that was not a good shot by Talley, even though he knows he has to create some offense. They need to go through Kaycock.
Here's Daly on top to Carter. Hens operating on offense with 6:10 remaining. And an 86-70 advantage. Daly, back door, hesitated, pumped in the air, and somehow found an angle.
The eighth assist by Anthony Mosley, who's having a terrific job running, doing a terrific job running the ball club.
New career high for Anthony Mosley. 8 assists, only 1 turnover for Champ. Taylor, a shot over Carter. He forced it, and a rebound by Ryan Daly, his 6th. Things looking a little bit better for Delaware as they're getting some stops and time winding down in this one. For a moment, a little worrisome with the foul situation, but time now on the side of the Hens. Carter, a couple dribbles and a handoff to Allen, who has 19. Bryant inside to Carter. Faces up on Kaycock, back to Allen. Open for three, and that puts Delaware up 21.
Great movement off the ball by Ryan Allen. A nice inside-out attack by Eric Carter to kick the ball out to a wide open Allen. Delaware's zone now has frustrated UNCW the last two possessions.
The lead 21, 22 points for Ryan Allen, his second career 20-point performance. He had 24 against Cordell, and Allen
who have been slumping a little bit from beyond the arc over the past two games, making 4 of 14. Today, back in rhythm. Gary has been off the mark all day from downtown. He misses a three, rebound Bryant. And now a miss from in close into the hands of Carter. Looks like UNCW is, and now tallies some extra bumping. Sprinting over Ryan Daly for words to the senior. I like that. Ryan Daly not going to let Tally bump his senior cap.
Absolutely, and a good job there of officiating by Clarence Armstrong, as you mentioned, a local resident who's become a big-time official, and I love the fact he got right involved, tried to quiet him down. Ryan Daly coming in just to protect his teammate.
Nice job by Ryan Daly. He's the type of teammate you want to have. He works hard. He has your back. Tally, frustrated, gave an extra nudge to Anthony Mosley, and it's just a frustrating day for the Seahawks, who are going to go back to Wilmington, getting swept on the season, it looks like, unless a miracle happens in the next 5 minutes for the Seahawks.
In a completely different game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
58-56 down at Trask, and this one now going to be played maybe by Delaware into the hundreds.
92-70 after the free throw by Mosley. Champ passed on Delaware's all-time scoring chart. Another Delaware native, Mark Edgerson, Glasgow graduate. Called him Love when he was playing here with Juwan Carter from Tatnall, that team in the mid-2000s. Chance been doing it for quite some time for the Hens, and two free throws makes it 93-70. As Gary and Brown will have a catch around the perimeter. Kaycock on the bench, Tally on the bench after an emotional outburst by the senior as they go inside to Estime. He makes the layup, and with that call by C.B. McGrath to pull his two guys, he's kind of calling off the dogs a bit.
And I think you're right. He also wants to protect Kaycock here. He did injure whether it was his knee or his ankle on that fall over the shot, trying to affect the shot of Ryan Allen. Delaware doing a good job here of using the shot clock. As we mentioned, it's in a bad position, but the Delaware bench doing a nice job of communicating as it winds itself down.
Bryant to Daly. Daly getting in close, kicks out Mosley. 6 seconds for Champ from the corner. Off the dribble, off the mark, and a rebound by Jalen Forns. He'll push for the Seahawks across half court. Top of the key, he stops playing with four fouls, loses grip, out of bounds. It'll be Delaware basketball.
Well, Delaware zone has bothered UNCW here late in the game. It's a spacious 2-3, but without Kaycock in there, there's no one to affect the defense in the middle. Delaware can expand it a little bit more, contest those long-range shooters.
Under 4 minutes we go. Delaware in control of this one. They had to weather a storm with Walker and Johnson fouling out and Carter having the four fouls. They did so. Daly in close, lobs into Carter, pass deflected, ball loose. Daly comes back up with it, and Allen will reset with 8. 6 seconds for Allen to the left side. Allen, pull up, Jay from 3, back iron, no, and a rebound by Brown. Loops it ahead to Forns, running the floor underneath. Fouled hard by Anthony Mosley, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Good job by Mosley to get back and at least make that a tough guy contest shot. Ryan Allen after the miss, instead of sprinting back though, he stepped up to challenge the rebound, and that's what allowed the run out by UNCW.
3:30 left until Delaware can complete the season sweep of the defending CAA champions. We'll be back in a moment with a 93-72 lead for the Hens. Left to go. Delaware up 93-72. Two players fouled out, Walker and Johnson. Only 7 scholarship players, so Delaware had to go to Connor Rufo off the bench, who played very well in 5 minutes, scored a free throw, drew a foul on Marcus Bryant, but Anthony Mosley, his high school teammate from Samford, playing maybe his best game of the season. 15 points, 8 rebounds, 8 assists for Champ.
This is as well as I've seen Anthony Mosley play. In terms of his offense, he's been very confident. It started off with that mid-range shot, which he hasn't been doing a lot of, and then he got to the basket off some back cuts from the weak side against that zone. So he's been really creative, but I just love the fact that even though he's scoring, he continues to play solid defense and his share of the ball and taking very good care of it with 8 assists, as you mentioned, only 1 turnover. Terrific job by Mosley here this afternoon.
Forns makes both free throws, 10 points for the second time this year against Delaware, double figures for the 10th time on the year for Jalen Forns. Got himself into some early foul trouble, as did several other Seahawks. Playing late in the game now. Bryant, a pass inside to Carter. Nice defense by Marcus Bryant. He blocks a shot of Carter. Another down the floor we go with the Hens up 93-74. Bryant turns, shoots over Eric Carter. Short, rebounded by Ryan Allen, who was fouled by Jalen Forns, and that'll send Forns back to North Carolina. It'll do it for him, his fifth foul in 20 minutes, 10 points for the sophomore.
Eric Carter's done a nice job of coming in and playing intelligently since he got that last foul. He's just stayed square. He's not over-challenging, but still effective in there. He made Bryant shoot over top of him, which is exactly what you want to do, and he continues to play hard at the offensive end with some really nice passing. So the ability of Eric Carter to kind of learn how to play with these fouls is going to be really important, as we've already documented with this short bench and other players in foul trouble.
Allen at the stripe, the team's best free throw shooter percentage-wise at 82% on the year. Misses the first with 2:55 left. Allen, 2 points away from matching his career-high 24 he had against Cornell. And he makes his second free throw, 23 now for the freshman from DeMatha. Brown will dribble up the court. Bryant, elbow jump shot left side, fading away, around and out, rebounded by Ryan Daly, who's having a heck of a game himself. 27 points for Ryan Daly, one away from the career high he set against the Seahawks in January of last year.
Well, Delaware's used the shot clock here late in the game very intelligently. They've let it run down inside 7 before they even think of attacking. It shortens up the game and denies the Seawolves any opportunity of coming back.
Bryant, a pass inside to Champ. Champ with 17 points. And the Hens pouring it on. They're 4 away from the century mark. A strip by Bryant. A chance for 2 more. Down the floor he goes. He'll bring it back out into the corner. Working some clock. A heady play by the redshirt junior. Carter to Darian Bryant on the wing with 1:59. He'll get into the paint to Daly. A 3 on the way, off the mark, into the hands of Marcus Bryant for the Seahawks. Gary has it, and they'll slow things up. Some starters off the floor for the Seahawks as a 3-point shot off the bench from Nick Powell. Gets rebounded by Allen, saving it out of bounds.
That last possession by Delaware, I just love what Darian Bryant did. A lot of players with that kind of lead would have attacked. It would have been selfish trying to score. He took the ball to the side, let the clock run down, and then got Ryan Daly a wide open shot. So great job by Darian Bryant just understanding the time score situation.
And Martin Inglesby going to give Ryan Daly a well-deserved break to end the next 1 minute and 27 of this game. Champ Mosley will sit with him. Curtis Lochner, Connor Rufo back in.
Well, good. Great to see Curtis Lochner and Connor Rufo. Definitely deserve some more minutes. Get back into the game here and finish this one out.
Allen going inside to Carter. Carter turns. Now backing down Bryant. Cross court to Lochner. Lochner fires up a 3 at the end of the shot clock, an air ball. He had to force that one up, and a turnover by the Hens. Shot clock violation.
I think Eric just didn't realize. He was trying to be unselfish and get the ball to Lochner to take a shot. Just didn't realize it had gone down that far.
Brown. Pass to Stime. Foul line jump shot is good. Rattles through. 96-74. See if the Hens can't get 4 more points on the board.
Well, Curtis can run the club as well as anybody. The walk-on doing a nice job here of handling it versus a very quick defender.
Bring the ball up the floor. Couple between the leg dribbles. Goes to Bryant. Bryant flashing high is Rufo. Jab step by Bryant, who has 9 points. Now Rufo. Dribble handoff to Bryant. He'll drive. And Bryant missing strong. Rebounded by Bryant for UNCW. Brown on the run. Estime trying to add to his total. Cannot. Rebound by Curtis Lochner. Ball knocked out of his hands. Rufo comes away with it. Shot clock unplugged. And Delaware going to win by 20 points, 96-76. Delaware had two players foul out, no scholarship players left on the bench, but will pull off the victory. 96-76 going to be the final. A happy belated birthday to Ryan Daly. What a present. 27 points for the sophomore who celebrated his birthday yesterday and today celebrates a season sweep of the Seahawks.
What a terrific win by Delaware, overcoming foul trouble, overcoming a hot start by UNCW, doing a great job of defending Kaycock inside with foul trouble, and a nice job off the bench by Connor Rufo to really give Delaware some quality minutes when the game was in the balance.
We'll take a timeout when we come back. It's the American Spirit Federal Credit Union post-game show. 96-76, the final from the Bob Carpenter Center, and the Hens get back above 500, 9-8 on the year, and their record back to 500 at home, 4-4 here at the Bob Carpenter Center. Well-deserved win by the Hens, and we'll talk about it when we come back.
Saving money on Shell gasoline just got a lot simpler. Log on to Value Days.
All right, thank you for joining us.
Catherine, thanks for coming.
Thank you for keeping us company.